Greetings and blessings upon you all. Welcome to Faith Chapel Presbyterian Church's worship. Way back in the beginnings of Faith Chapel, they worshiped beneath a tree. And so we gather together today to worship simply and wonderfully. So bring yourselves together, gather in, and prepare thyselves to worship our Lord.
We have heard about you, God of all power. You made the world out of kindness, creating order out of confusion. You made each one of us in your own image. Your fingerprint is on every soul. So we praise you. We praise and worship you. We have heard about you, Jesus Christ. The carpenter who left his tools in trade, the poor man who made others rich, the healer who let himself be wounded, the criminal on whom the soldiers spat, not knowing they were fouling the face of God, the Savior who died and rose again. So we praise you. We praise and worship you. We have heard about you, Holy Spirit. You broke the bonds of every race and nation to let God speak in every tongue. You made disciples drunk with grace. You converted souls and emptied pockets. You showed how love made all things new and opened the doors to change and freedom. So we praise you. We praise and worship you. God in three persons, Blessed Trinity, we ask for your presence to enter this space. We know that in self-giving love, your very nature teaches us how to love one another. Father and Creator, Son and Redeemer, Spirit and Advocate, we call upon you to teach us this hour. Teach us to pray. Teach us to love. Teach us to be one as you are one. With all of our divisions we create with our own biases, from social class to race, from gender to age, from ability to different abilities, we know we still have much to learn. Teach us this hour, we pray. Amen. All this I have told you, so that you will not fall away. They will put you out of the synagogue. In fact, the time is coming when anyone who kills you will think they are offering a service to God. They would do such things because they have not known the Father or me. I have told you this, so that when their time comes, you will remember that I warned you about them. I did not tell you this from the beginning, because I was with you. But now I am going to him who sent me. None of you ask me, where are you going? Rather, you are filled with grief because I have said these things. But very truly I tell you, it is for your good that I am going away. Unless I go away, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. When he comes, he will prove the world to be in the wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment. About sin, because people do not believe in me. About righteousness, because I am going to the Father, where you can see me no longer. And about judgment, because the prince of this world now stands condemned. I have much more to say to you, more than you can now bear. But when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all the truth. He will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears, and he will tell you what is yet to come. He will glorify me, because it is from me that he will receive what he will make known to you. All that belongs to the Father is mine. That is why I said, the Spirit will receive from me what he will make known to you. This is the word of our Lord.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We use that invocation when we are baptizing in our faith, the Presbyterian faith. It is called the Triune God, Father, Son, and Spirit. Now, there have been many people who have tried to explain and give examples of what this triune God is, and I'll give you some of those. One would be water. You have water, as in you pour a bottle of water. But it also takes the form of ice and also can take the form of steam. So, three in one. Another example is, the shamrock. The shamrock is a good example. It has the three separate leaves, but yet it is attached to one single stem. It is three in one. Unless you're fortunate enough to get a four-leaf clover, and then you're lucky. And usually around this day, there is a short clip, or I shouldn't say short, it's probably 10 minutes or so. But there's this clip that goes around on Facebook among those of us in ministry, and it is two Irishmen who I just can't shake it. They look like leprechauns to me. But these two Irishmen, it's a cartoon. But they're harping on St. Patrick to explain this triune God to them. And so in this little video clip of cartoon, St. Patrick uses these different examples trying to explain the triune God to
these two Irishmen. And they're rather grumbly, too. So, but each time that St. Patrick lifts up one of these, like I did with the water and the ice, and there you go, they raise back to him, no, that's not really triune God, that's something else. And they're right. Because what it truly boils down to is that we're human. We are human beings. We are incapable of knowing and understanding all that there is in the universe. And in order to understand God and God's fullness, you'd have to understand everything. And we're not capable of such a thing. And that's not downplaying who we are or belittling us in any way, shape, or form. It's just simply, we're not God. Did you create the earth? Did you create water? Did you create air? How about the birds and the fishes? And the animals? Did you create the very first humans? Did you create day and night? And actually, night was created before day. No, none of us have. Are we capable of continuing to create? Yes. Yes, we can. We can take something that already exists and do a multitude of these things. Yes, we can. But we are not the original creator. And that is the Father, the original creator. God over all, the central being that everything comes back to, because that is where it came from, the Father. And then we have the Son. The Son is both God and man. He is both creator and created. Now, if that doesn't boggle your mind, wait for the Holy Spirit. But this is part of the awe and the wonder of God. Do you want to really believe and put your faith into something that you can fully understand? I mean, we have so many systems and institutions upon the earth right at this time, and can you say that you have absolute faith and belief in any one of them? Even what we call church on earth, I don't have absolute belief and faith in. I have absolute faith and belief in Jesus. Both God and man, yes, I believe. But not in the things that we create. The body of believers, there's hope for that. But do I have absolute belief in it? No, I do not. That rests solely in the one who leads it and creates it, Jesus. And so that's the Son. And the Son came to be the Son of Man, so that we could be reconciled back to God, so that we could be forgiven for the sins that we have done, for all the things that we say, nope, God, we're not doing that, even though you told us not to, you know, or to do, or not to do. Jesus reconciles us back to God. Once again, the created is brought back to the Creator. And now the Holy Spirit. Now that's an interesting thing. That's something that's intangible. We can't touch it. We can't see it. We can't smell it, taste it, or hear it other than inside of ourselves. The Holy Spirit does not manifest as a spirit or a ghost, but it has a packaging, if you will, a temple, a residence inside each and every believer. I told you the Holy Spirit was going to be the one that kind of woo-woo makes it a little difficult. Yes, if you are a believer that Jesus came to reconcile us to God, to forgive our sins so that we could be reconciled to God, you're probably packing around the Holy Spirit. Now, can you hear the Holy Spirit? Do you feel the Holy Spirit within you? That takes some doing. That takes the desire to feel, to know, and to hear the Holy Spirit within you. And that Holy Spirit that's inside of you is God too. Everything that is created and exists does so because of the Creator. And the Creator resides within inside of you. No different than Jesus was Son of God, Son of Man. The Holy Spirit that is in you is God too. Imagine that. That every day we walk around with God. Now, may make you cringe a little bit. Ooh, I really shouldn't have done that yesterday. It's okay. Because Jesus did the heavy lifting for us so that we could be forgiven. All you need to do is ask. And God the Father set it all into motion so that everything could be brought back to Him. And you have to allow the awe and the wonder in. And stop trying to be the all-knowing. And just enjoy a God that loves you. Amen. Unison Affirmation of Faith. In a time before all knowing, God is. And God's breath fills the emptiness, creating a universe, a world, an ecology, a biology, and us, humankind. All humankind. No exceptions, no imperfections. And all of us beloved just as we are. In a time before all knowing, Christ Jesus watches the creating and steps out into creation, becoming, living, dying, and rising, all for us. All humankind, no exceptions, no reservations, all of us. Just as we are, God's beloved. In a time before all knowing, the Spirit is. and moves through every part of creation, consoling, interceding, leading, and refreshing all the world, including us. All humankind, no exceptions, no differentiations, all of us, just as we are, God's beloved. Guide us, O God, by your Holy Spirit, that all of our prayers and all of our lives may serve your will and show your love. We pray, Lord, for the people and circumstances that weigh on our hearts and minds. We pray for we lift our prayers to you, Lord, as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. He will my share and portion me as long as life endures. My chains are
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, send us out to live lives that glorify you. Help us to be people of peace. Empower us to recognize your call in our families, in our communities, in our workplaces and schools, in our churches, and in our world. Amen. Just as God's word was sent into the world to heal and redeem, so God sends you into the world this day to be light and love, healing and hope. Go now to be light for the world, and may the grace and peace of God the Creator, the Redeemer, and the Sustainer come upon you this day and remain with you always. Amen.